The 88th annual Santa Claus Parade will wind its way through downtown Toronto this coming Sunday afternoon. And our Susan Hay is standing by live at a secret warehouse where everything is being made ready for the big day. Susan?
Jane, I walked in here today and I can't tell you, these floats are more spectacular this year than they were last year, and they were pretty amazing last year, John, and I can't believe the detail and the preparation put into each and every float.
You notice the paint? The paint, they're using a much more fluorescent type of paint this year. More animation, there are more floats. It's the biggest ever.
How many floats?
24.
24 floats?
Counting the big guys.
That's right. We won't talk about the big guy. We're saving that for a little
bit
later.
He has a new one.
Now tell us about Santa's On His Way, speaking of Santa.
Well, that's that little half-hour program we do every year, which runs on Saturday night at 7 o'clock, and immediately before the parade broadcast on Sunday, football permitting.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really a look behind the scenes at how this, everything comes together, from the secret workshop to what happens when to get everything from the secret workshop down to the parade, and what happens down at the Charles Bickford School and along the parade route.
Now tell us about the parade route, because you should get there a few hours before.
You really should to get a good spot. People take chairs, they take all kinds of things with them, but you'll notice there it starts at around Christie Pits, Christie Street in Bloor, then it moves east along over to University.
Right in front of the Hospital for Sick Children.
Yes, isn't that
too?
When it goes down University and then along Queen to Yonge, down Yonge to Front and ends over around, I guess it's Church and Front Street, and it disperses there. So there's plenty of spots to find to watch the parade. They're expecting 750,000 again this year.
The biggest ever, you said.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what countries involved this year?
Well, the U.S. networks are going to be having their own broadcast. That's going to be seen by 35 million. The global broadcast is going to be seen in New Zealand, Australia, through Canada, of course, more than 3 million in Canada alone. And then, of course, the Russians are going to be showing it to all of the Commonwealth of Independent States.
Sunnybrook Hospital, too, big involvement. It's their third year.
It's
Tell
wonderful.
Us about the noses.
All the volunteer, all the nurses and so on, they're going to go up and down the parade route selling these little foam noses. Keeps
Rudolph's
the nip away.
Nose, that's
Rudolph
right.
Keeps the nip away.
Keeps you warm, and it goes towards Sunnybrook Hospital, yep, and to the parade.
That's right. They're $2, three for $5, and a lot of people buy them, and it's terrific. They raise a lot of money for charities.
Well,
wonderful.
Thank you, John, for joining
thank
us tonight, because
I
know this is a busy weekend for John Daw.
And I'll see you down there, I hope.
A Sunday. I wouldn't miss Santa.
Great.
4:30, if you can't make it to the parade, is the broadcast on Global, so we'll be televising the parade at that time. We had a busy day today in terms of weather, because we have a snow squall watch currently in effect for Superior East and Sault Ste. Marie. And by tomorrow, a lot of snow on the ground, at least 15 to 20 centimeters of snow. Let's take a look at our map tonight, because the south